Namaste and welcome to our Sunday Slowdown Restorative Yin. So for today's practice, we're going to be connecting with the element of wood in traditional Chinese medicine. We'll be working with our liver and gallbladder meridians, so to ease the flow of qi, energize us. We've chosen these specifically because we're in a period of transition and change again. Just like the bamboo, we want to be flexible, adaptable, and resilient to change. The liver and the gallbladder are responsible for digestion, metabolism, filtering, cleansing, clearing. So we have to clear and shed the old layers first in order to invite in the new change. Let's bring our hands together at our heart center to open our practice with three Oms, the primordial vibration of the universe. Inhale fully. Exhale completely through open mouth to discharge the breath. Inhale to prepare. Om. Inhale. Om. Inhale. Om. Hands to your eyebrow center. Namaste. Thank you for joining me. So just to reiterate, when we practice yin, it's a very different pace of yoga compared to hatha yoga. It's cooling, reflective, introspective, inward looking. We come into a shape or a pose. We resolve to stay in that pose. And as we stay in that pose and remain still, we soften, relax, drop down into our deeper level, the deeper connective tissues. And we meet our edge within that pose. And then we soften and extend that edge gradually. So the sensations that you want to experience are going to be mild sensations. If you experience any intense or uncomfortable sensations, I invite you to have some bodily awareness and come back from that edge. Know that during this practice, the silence within which we hold our poses will allow the thoughts to surface. The lower, deeper feelings that we have, sensations just rise to the surface. The liver helps us to confront, face, accept those changes. Sometimes we may not know our boundaries, our limits, so the liver meridian helps us to establish those boundaries, especially around negative emotions such as anger, frustration, irritation. By clearing away some of that negativity, we leave room to inviting more positivity. And when I say positivity, it includes acceptance, resilience, understanding. We're going to start by tapping. So we have sort of pairs of meridians running throughout our body. And by tapping, we are activating and stimulating different acupressure points that connect to those meridian channels. We're going to start with our hand, our karate chop. So I invite you to bring your fingers into a gentle fist, just folding your fingers. And then you can use your knuckles or you can use your fingertips. And we're gently going to tap different places around our body. As we tap, we're going to repeat positive affirmations. Today in yin practice, I prefer to use the metta bhavana, loving kindness. So we will chant different phrases of the chant. As we move around our body. You may connect with some in particular, in which case I invite you to chant those silently or out loud. You're in the privacy of your own home. So let's get started. Drop down into your breath. Notice your breath, the pattern of your breath. Begin to connect with your physical self here on the mat. As you tune into your body, this helps you tune out of your external environment. Your breath is the bridge between your mind and your body. Inhale for four. Hold the breath in for four. Exhale slowly for six. Hold the breath out for two. Coherent breathing. Inhale for four, three, two, one. Hold the breath in. Four, three, two, one. Release the breath. Six, five, four, three, two, one. Hold the breath out. Two, one. Again. Inhaling for four. Holding for four. Exhaling for six. Holding out for two. And then return to your natural breath. Let's prepare for our tapping, bringing your hand as we visited earlier, and begin to tap on your karate chop that we are drawn to. We're going to connect with our positive affirmations. So for this one, let's start with, may I be full of loving kindness. So repeat that self to your silently to yourself three times, or out loud because you're at home and you can do. So may I be filled with loving kindness. May I be filled with loving kindness. Now we're going to release that, and we're going to take our index and middle finger, and we're going to take it to the inside of our eyebrow. So just where our nose meets our eyebrow, we're going to tap there. And perhaps this time we say, may I be safe and protected from harm. May I be safe and protected from harm. May I be safe and protected from harm. Let's go to the outer edge of our eye. So we're going to go to our outer edge of our eye. So we're working with our liver and gallbladder meridian. And they kind of work all over our body, but we have different parts of the liver meridian around our face. And as we tap, we connect with all the different meridians. Let's move to the underneath our eye. So that always reminds me of The Handmaid's Tale. Let's tap that away. So some feminist power here. May I be strong and healthy. May I be strong and healthy. Let's go under the nose now. And so this is where we begin to connect with our liver and our large intestine. So under the nose, just above the top lip. We're going to go to our chin. Again, now we're working with our liver meridian. So the liver meridian passes through here. And perhaps now we chant, may I be happy and live life with ease. May I be happy and live life with ease. From here, we're going to come down to our collarbone. So now we might want to use four fingers together. So we can work with one side of the body, because as we work with one side of the body, it's mirrored onto the other side. If you have more time at home, you might want to do both sides, but we'll work with one side. Both sides are stimulated and activated here. So tapping on the collarbone here. So here, the small intestine, the stomach, the spleen, meridians pass through here. Let's go to our sternum. So maybe here, may I be filled with loving kindness. May I be filled with loving kindness. And I like to bring both hands to my heart space here. May I be filled with loving kindness. Let's go under the arm here. So now we're working with the heart meridian, the pericardium. May I be safe and strong. May I be safe and protected from all harm. May I be safe and protected from all harm. And from here, we're going to go to the top of the crown. So again, I like to use both hands here and just either side of that soft space in the middle where your fontanelle is. So we're just on the either side of that. May I be strong and healthy in body and mind. May I be strong and healthy in body and mind. And now back to our inner wrist here. So our inner wrist, just before we go back to the karate chop. So may I be strong and healthy. May I be happy and live life with ease, whatever you connect with. And then back to the karate chop. So that's just awakening us up, connecting with our positive affirmations. We can let go now. I'm now going to move to the whole of the arm. So we are going to work, tap the whole of each arm. And we're going to start with the shoulder. So the yang meridians go down the outside. So I'm starting at the outside, working all the way down the outside of the arm. I'm going to stop just at my elbow for a moment. So you can use your four fingers or your knuckles here. And then I'm coming down to my wrist. And again, I'm just going to stop at the outside of my wrist for a moment. And then I'm going to carry on all the way down to my thumb. So this is where my lung meridian passes through and it ends here. And now I'm going to come on the inside. So now I'm going to start up my little finger, work all the way along my hand, back onto my inner wrist. Let's spend a little bit of time here along the inner arm. So the yin, so the yang and yin meridians. So the two pairs of meridians, one is the yang, which is the more dominant active meridian. And the other one is much a cooling, more introspective meridian. I'm going to stop at my elbow, in the inside of my elbow, all the way up to my shoulder again. So we're going to do that to the other side, all the way down the outside of the arm, stop around the elbow. So here we stop at these different acupressure points. So there's quite a few here. So down the outside of the arm is the lung meridian, and the inside of the arm is the heart meridian. Down to my wrists, let's stop here for a while. And then let's go all the way to the thumb. And then back to the inside of the arm now, little finger, all the way along your wrist, inner arm, stop at the elbow, along the inner arm, to the shoulder again. Now, just tapping at your heart space, down to where your ribs are, let's follow the ribs down to the outside of your abdomen, and down the middle of the abdomen, then your hips, outside of your thighs, stop at your knees for a moment, and then let's go down one shin and the other shin, your feet. And now we're going to come back on behind our legs. So you might need to extend your leg to go around the back of it, go to the underside of the knee, your back of your thighs, your buttocks, and then back here, back to your hips. Along your abdomen, weaving your way, zigzagging. So our liver meridian sort of zigzags along here. Let's go to our kidneys just before we finish. So our bladder and kidneys are at the back. Gall bladder as well. And then back to the heart space. And then yes. Oh, I feel all waken up. So let's move our block if you're sitting on a block. Now we're going to come into our first yin pose. So because we're working with the liver meridian, so the liver meridian runs all the way from around here, down, zigzags across our abdomen, and then down the sort of thigh, and then comes to the inside of our leg, all the way down towards our foot, and comes to our big toe, and ends at our big toe. So this is the journey of our liver meridian. Now the liver meridian is said to be the general of the army. The liver is what helps us plan, get things done, directive, but it's also where we process some of our stronger emotions. So the liver is a great processor. So we process some of our strong emotions, anxiety, anger, frustration, irritation. Those are all processed here. So to come into our first pose, shoelace, two options, yogis. Half shoelace, extend your right leg long and cross your left leg over your right leg so that your knees are aligned here. So let's go this way so you can see me a little bit better. So you can see my knee is above my left knee is above my right knee here. That's half shoelace pose. This might be enough for you So you stay here. Second option is to bring in your heel of your right foot so that your feet are next to your hips here. And here you can see again, your knees are stacked. Now it doesn't matter, I'm now wearing black, it's not very helpful, but it doesn't matter how much that gap is. There's a gap there, that's fine. Don't worry about that gap. If it feels really uncomfortable anywhere, you can place a cushion underneath your knee if you want there, between the top knee and the bottom knee. And then I want you to weave your fingers through the toes that are closest to you from the underside. And then take your thumb. So you'll either have one leg extended, so your right leg might be extended, so you'll have your left foot in your hand. Take your thumb. And then between your big toe and your second toe, just apply some gentle pressure there. There's the liver acupressure point there. So we're here in shoelace, either half shoelace. Again, we're all applying pressure. So that's our left foot in our right hand. We're just pressing our thumb into that place. So it's the space between the two bones of your big toe and your second toe. If you have your right foot near you, then you can do the same on that side. But remember, we only need to work with one half of our body. It affects and is mirrored in the other half. So this is going to begin to feel quite challenging at your hips, perhaps your knees. In yin, we come into a pose, we hold that pose, and then we resolve to stay in that pose for anything between 3 and 5 minutes in our practice today. So we'll be here for 3 minutes. I have a timer. And you'll begin to feel all kinds of emotions and feelings arising. The liver meridian finds pressure difficult to cope with. And here you might begin to sense some pressure. Because we're here for 3 minutes, you can start in half shoelace and then move to the full variation of shoelace. We come to our comfortable edge and we meet that edge. And then as we soften and create more space, as we begin to work at a deeper level, we might create enough space to extend the pose. Only might, not necessarily. We're here for another 2 minutes. And I'm going to give you the option now of folding forward with your upper body so that you come into a forward fold. Now, this is going to intensify the sensation in your hips. You can rest your eyebrow center on your knee if it reaches the knee. Alternatively, you can have your cushion on your top knee and rest your head on your cushions. Yogi's choice. We're here for 1 more minute. Think about everything you wish to let go of, things that you need to work through, any negative emotions or thoughts or feelings that arise here. Take this opportunity in your practice today to process those in order to welcome and adapt to new challenges. We need to be fairly confident that we have already faced and overcome some of our older challenges. Perhaps older difficulties, those that have been deeply ingrained or embedded, inhibit or prevent change. 3 more breaths here in half shoelace on your left side. Take a full breath in. Inhale to lift your gaze, followed by your heart. Release your toes where your fingers are interlaced and uncross your legs. Place heels on the earth, hands either side of you. And let's windshield wiper our knees one way, then the other. Just to release here. Perhaps you need to extend your leg and give it a little more of a vigorous shake. So shaking is a really good way of releasing energy, encouraging flow of chi through our body. Let's go the other way now. So this time we're going to take our right leg over our left leg. So again, yogi's option, half shoelace, left leg extended, cross your right leg over your left, bringing your right knee above your left knee. Again, interlace your fingers in your toes, so you can see, and then take your thumb between the big toe and the second toe, and then just press through, press gently there, and then gradually you can increase the pressure. You can let go at any point of that toe if it begins to feel painful. So sometimes if there's any tenderness in those acupressure points, that's an indication for us to perhaps pay a little bit more attention to those energy channels or those organs that those energy channels are connected to, and either the emotions and the energetic subtle aspects of that organ and meridian, or perhaps a more physical aspect to that organ. You also have the option of bringing your left heel towards your sit bone. So again, we'll be here for 3 minutes. Connect with what you wish to release, discharge, process. Any anger, frustration, irritation. And with lockdown, many of us had those strong feelings, perhaps towards our loved ones, perhaps towards our governments, perhaps towards other people. Let's release those feelings with each out breath, letting go. Name those feelings, label those emotions. Allow that negative energy to drain away. We're here for another minute or so. So if you wish to fold forward, begin to reach with your eyebrow center down towards your knees, coming into your forward fold. Again, you can have the option of creating a little support by placing cushions on top of your knees and resting your eyebrow center on your cushions. So yin is very much the yoga of confronting resistance, finding those edges. And allowing those edges to soften, give way gradually. 3 more breaths here. Signal to your body that you're about to move. Inhaling. Lift your gaze, followed by your heart. Release your toes. Release your legs. Place your feet on the earth. And then let's windshield wiper them. Perhaps you stretch them out and give them a little shake. Maybe you even rub around the back of your knees so you'll have felt some energy pooling in different places, perhaps at the back of your knees. So remember that tapping that we did. So those joints, that's why we pay a little bit of extra attention to our joints. So that will help release. So give it a little shake. Right. Now we're going to move into half frog pose. Pardon me, my hesitation. So frog pose, this is going to be quite challenging because it's really working here on the inside of our groin here, the hips. So remember how the liver meridian comes down here, goes towards our inner thigh, our gallbladder comes here. So our gallbladder really comes in here on the back, our hips in here. So this is why we're going to work with frog pose. Now, make sure you have your blanket on the earth for this one so that you've got some nice soft padding. Reach for your pillows or your bolster. So I've got my pillows here, so I'll show you with my pillows. And I'm going to use two pillows here, and then I can always change as my pose, as I soften through my pose. Okay, so have your pillows lengthways on your mat. You're on your knees here. So come onto all fours. And then what we're going to do is part our knees, and then we can bring our heart to rest on our bolster or pillows. You will feel it intensely here. Now, if that feels too intense for you, and it may well do, let's do half variation. So half variation is one leg is extended on the earth, and the other leg you create a heart, the letter H. So you'll notice that this feels less intense. But this is variation one, half frog pose. Your legs look like the letter H, for happy. Or you can have both knees out and then support your heart space. That's going to feel much more intense. Find the variation that works for you. We're going to, so you could come into this full variation and think, oh, I can't, I'm not able to sustain that. That is beyond my edge. This is not a mild sensation for me. This is a very strong, intense sensation. So let's back away, ease away from that edge and come to the variation that works for you. So we'll be here for less time. So here we'll be only here for 2 minutes because I know this feels intense. Use your breath to breathe into the spaces where you feel tension, compression, challenge. So that's the rule of yoga, essentially, using your breath. Your breath has wonderful magical powers. It is how we direct energy, it's how we release tension, how we slow down and connect with our parasympathetic system. So you might begin to, your nervous system might start responding in a pose that feels very challenging. Now, if you're in half frog pose, make sure you swap over now. So let's go the other way. If you're in half frog pose, let's extend one leg long and create an H with the other leg. Rest your eyebrows center if you wish, or you can rest on your ears. Yogi's choice. We won't be here for long. If you're in the full frog, you can come back and sit into child's pose in order to rest at any point. So come back and rest in child's pose if that becomes too much. Let's have five more breaths here. Sit down. Breathe into your inner hips here, inner hip flexors. And then very mindfully and with great care, we're going to ease out of our frog variation, and we're all going to come into supported child pose. So have your block, your bolster, sorry, or your pillows and cushions, pull them in towards you so that your knees are on either side, hands on top of your bolster, so that your palms are on top of each other, and then rest your eyebrow center on top of your hands. And let's just rest here. So this should help release that strong sensation inside your hips. Three full breaths here in child's pose, supported child's pose. And then all together, inhale, lift your gaze, lift your heart, walk your hands back towards you. From here, we're going to transition into dragon pose. So again, we're working very much around this area here where the gallbladder and liver meridians pass through. So have your pillows or your bolster or your low footstool. So if you have low footstool here, so you know I have a low footstool here. I'll leave my bolster there, but you can use your low footstool here if you wish, at the top of your mat. Come onto all fours. Let's extend that left leg long for a moment. So you reach back with your left leg, and that's going to be quite freeing and releasing of energy. Then step forward with your right foot to the outside of your right hand. If you need to pad your left knee, I invite you to pad your left knee. So place a folded blanket underneath your left knee if you wish. And then really sink into your hips here. Now, if you have your bolster or your cushions or your low footstool, place your hands on your bolster or low cushion. Have your right foot to the outer edge of your mat. So we're in high flying dragon here. So we'll stay in high flying dragon for a minute, and then we'll transition into low flying dragon. Here you can be gazing ahead, or you can be gazing down towards the earth, so the back of your neck is long. Breathe into your hips. Perhaps you use your ujjayi breath, so your ocean sounding breath, that constricted breath at the back of your throat. Breathing in and out through your nose. But as you exhale, you're constricting the back of your throat, so it makes the sound of the ocean. One more breath here in high flying dragon. Now you can stay in high flying dragon, or you can come onto your forearms. And if you're coming onto your forearms, interlace your fingers here. So your forearms can be on your block, on your bolster, on your pillows. You could have a mountain of pillows here. And if you have none of those available, you might have your forearms directly on the earth. This will be the most intense experience. So if this does not feel sustainable, come back onto your hands at any point. Now in yin yoga, we are working with strong emotions. We're really dropping down into a meditative practice. So in order to really have that experience of the gap between the thoughts, we come face to face with our thoughts. Use your breath. Perhaps you connect with one of those positive affirmations that we started our practice with. I am safe and protected from harm. I am filled with loving kindness. One more full breath here. In low dragon. Inhale. Lift your head, come onto your hands. Now we're going to transition into pigeon pose here. Now, two options for pigeon pose. The first one is the more intense variation. So it might be that this is not the one you want to be with today. So let's do this one first, and I'm going to show you the alternative. For those of you who want to go into Kapotasana, pigeon pose, take your right hand to the outside of your right foot here. And begin to shuffle your right foot all the way across the top of your mat. And then as you do that, come on to the little toe side edge of your right foot. So you can see I've come to the little toe side of my right foot. And then I'm going to lower my shin and knee to the earth. And then my right sit bone. So I'm now sitting on the earth on my right sit bone, my right thigh, and my right shin, and my right outer edge of my right foot. My left leg is extended long. So I'm going to make sure that I reach back with my left toes as far as they can go. And then I turn my heart. I'm on my hands, so I've got my palms in the earth, and I open my heart and lift my gaze. So I'm high pigeon here. Now that's option one. If this does not feel sustainable, or if there's a big gap between your right sit bone and the earth, use a cushion and place it underneath your sit bone so that you're sitting on your cushion. I'm going to just go this way around so that you can see me doing that. So I'll have my cushion underneath my sit bone here. So I'm sitting on my cushion here. So this is option one. If this feels too challenging, the variation is recline the pigeon. So then you would come onto your back and cross your right ankle on your left thigh and take your fingers behind your left hand. Keep turning that right knee out. So this is that figure of four reclined pigeon. So this is the alternative for pigeon. This is much more sustainable. It is the most accessible form of pigeon. You're doing exactly the same thing except upside down and in reverse. So find your pigeon. Keep reaching back with your left toe so that left leg is long behind you. Your right foot might be near your left hand or nowhere near your left hand. My right foot is quite near my left hip. We're going to be here for a moment. And then we're going to come into the sleeping swan variation. Now here, you can have your bolster in front of you so that you come onto your bolster with your heart space. So you have your bolster long way. You can rest on your bolster. It doesn't really matter if your bolster is side horizontal, you can have your forearms resting on your bolster. And then you bring your eyebrow center towards your forearms. So your bolster is there to lift the earth up towards you as you come into the sleeping swan variation. If you have no bolster available, you can also come directly to the earth and have your eyebrow center resting on your palms, on the earth. Your eye arms could be reaching forward. So come into your variation of swan, sleeping swan. We're going to be here for another 3 minutes. If you're on your back, you can always place your left foot on a bolster. So remember, you have your right ankle on your left thigh if you're in reclined pigeon. But you can always bring your left foot to rest on a bolster. Keep turning your right knee away from you if you're in the reclined variation. So yin is accessible in different ways, different shapes, but we're still working on the same meridians. and the same acupressure points around our body. So this variation in the reclined pigeon is the most restorative variation, most supportive variation. Let's have five more breaths here. Remember, you can use your ujjayi breath to bring in some extra comfort to you. It's a very soothing breath. And then inhaling, if you're in this classic variation of pigeon, to lift your gaze, lift your heart. Tuck your left toes and lift your left knee off. And then step back long with your right leg. Maybe just pedal your feet here to help the flow of energy. And then let's come into table while I bring my friends who are in the reclined variation to join us. So if you're in the reclined variation, you can stay here and switch. In fact, let's all go into dragon together. So let's bring your right foot to the earth and roll onto your side and come up through seat and then swing your legs around to join in table. I was going to suggest you switch right from the right leg to the left leg, but I think we want to do dragon together. So we're going to come onto dragon on our left side. Again, pad your right knee if you need to pad that knee. Let's step forward. Let's extend that left leg first just to give it a little stretch and then step it forward to the outside of our left hand. So that our left foot is on the outside edge of our mat here. You can be on with your hands on the earth, on your bolster, or your footstool. So you can see when you do that, it can lift you up quite high, really opens up across the heart. So we'll be in high variation for a couple of minutes before we move into the low flying dragon. If it begins to feel too intense in your knee, you can always lift that right knee off the earth, and that does add to the intensity. Keep shining your heart. Perhaps you're gazing directly ahead or maybe gazing down towards the earth. Breathe into your inner hip flexors. Careful not to dump weight into your wrists here. It's very easy to do that. You might begin to feel it on your wrists. So you can always create a little fist and use your fist instead, because that helps to protect your wrists. One more breath here in high flying pigeon. And on our exhale, we're going to come to the earth with our forearms. Interlace your fingers. Let's interlace your fingers the other way this time. So your forearms are either on your bolster, on your low footstool, or directly on the earth, yogi's choice. So now, as we're moving into our practice, perhaps start connecting with some more of your positive affirmations. I live life with ease. I have joy in my heart. I am free from troubles and worries. I am filled with loving kindness. Perhaps forgiveness. one more minute here. And if you're here in Low Flying Dragon, you can allow your neck and head to soften. At any point, you can come onto your hands. So you come into your pose, you meet your edge, you soften and relax into that edge. And if that edge at any point begins to present you with very strong and intense sensations, you can ease away from that edge at any point. Self-care, knowing the boundaries of your body. So our liver often doesn't know its boundaries. This is why the liver governs strong emotions like anger. So we work with that meridian in order to understand our limits, our boundaries, to establish and set those boundaries for ourselves and for others. Three more breaths here. And when you're ready, inhaling to come onto your hands, we transition into our variation of pigeon here. So we're staying with high pigeon. We take our left hand to the outside of our left foot and begin to walk our left foot across our mat. And then we shift and bring our sit bone to the earth, our shin and thigh to the earth, and at the outer edge of our left foot. And then when we're here, we're going to make our adjustments. So I'm going to take a cushion underneath my sit bone. I'm going to reach back with that right leg and make sure my alignment feels sustainable here. And if you're coming into the reclined variation, come onto your back. And this time we're going to cross our left ankle across our right thigh. And again, we can thread our hands behind our right thigh. We can have our right foot either in the air, so it's the horizontal to the earth, parallel to the earth, or we can have it resting on a bolster if we want a more restorative and supportive experience. In which case, release your hands and you can rest them on the earth or on your abdomen. Keep turning that left knee out if you're in the reclined variation of pigeon, supta, kapotasana, so that you are working that inner hip flexor on the left side. If you are in high pigeon, you can come to the earth. So lengthen first and then leading with your heart. Come down towards your bolster, your footstool, and then rest your eyebrow center on the backs of your hands. You can also come directly to the earth. Your hands can be underneath your eyebrow center, or you can reach with your hands in front of you, so that you create some length underneath your arms, armpits. And remember the angle of your left leg. So your foot could be, so your lower shin might be, your shin might be parallel to the short edge of the mat, or your left foot might be quite near your right hip, the inner hip flexor. All depends on how your body is designed. So we often see yogis bending, super flexible, contorting into these amazing shapes. And what we forget is that yoga was designed and practiced mostly by young men in India who were naturally more flexible than certainly me, a middle-aged woman. And often on social media, we have dancers and gymnasts who are naturally flexible, perhaps they are hypermobile. So we can't compare ourselves to those yogis. We are physically in a different place. One more breath here in sleeping pigeon, sleeping swan, over the reclined variation. Inhale to lift your gaze if you're on the earth with your eyebrow center. Tuck your right toes, lift your right knee, and then let's step back with that left leg. Just pedal those legs out for a moment. And then come into child's pose here. If you're in the reclined variation, let's hug your knees in. So coming out of your reclined pigeon, hug those knees in. So this is the same as a child's pose. It has the same sensation as a child's pose on the earth. So if ever a child's pose feels not the thing that you need today, this is the alternative. So we're either in Pavan Muktasan with our knees hugged to our heart or in child's pose. And we're all going to meet in the same place. So let's come onto our backs. I'm going to prepare for a few moments of Shavasana. For Shavasana today, I'm going to ask you to take your bolsters, your pillows, your cushions, choose one. And I'm going to ask you to place it across your abdomen here. So when you're lying down, your bolster is lying across your abdomen. At the place, so your lower abdomen, your hips, your pelvis, so across your body. Find even a heavy folded blanket will do here, so if there's no bolster available, you can fold a blanket. Place your blanket here. If you have your eye pillow, place your eye pillow over your eyes. And then let's soften here into the earth. Allow your feet to fall apart, arms away from your body, fingers gently curled. Connect with your heart space here. And with each out breath, release and let go of old habits, thoughts, patterns, sensations. I let go. I release. I forgive. And then with each in-breath, invite in a positive affirmation. May I be filled with loving kindness. May I be safe and protected from harm. May I be strong and healthy. May I be happy living life with ease and joy in my heart. Om sarve bhavantu sukhinaha, sarve santu niramayaha, sarve bhadrani pashyantu, ma kaschit dukh bhag bhavat. Om Shanti, Shanti, Shanti. Take a full breath in through your nose. Wash it out through open mouth. Reach overhead with your left arm. And roll over onto your left side. Your knees bent and curled in towards you. Then with helping hands, moving slowly and mindfully, inhaling to rise up into your comfortable seat. And when you're here, bring the soles of your feet together so that your knees are open, butterfly pose. Hands on your shins or ankles, or interlace your fingers between your toes. Soften your neck, soften your shoulders, your gaze down towards the earth. Take a full breath in, out through open mouth. Inhaling, hands to your heart center, closing our practice with one om and three shantis. Inhaling fully. Om
shanti,
shanti, shanti. Hands to your eyebrow center. Namaste. Dhanyavad. Thank you very much. Thank you, everyone. You can pull your knees together and give yourself a little hug. And a stretch, maybe, and a shake it out.